I've been recently working on a new video on orthogonality and the principle of incommensurability. I thought this would be a short video on orthogonality, but it turned into an epic journey and a much longer video. So I thought I would throw this one out there for fun. First of all, I want to congratulate Ken Wheeler on his successful talk at the Energy Conference. I heard it was a great success and that Ken was the belle of the ball of the Energy Conference. I'm told that the people in the audience hung on every word he said. I would have too. I was happy to see that he started to release parts of his talk on his YouTube channel right away, so I've been watching them. So, as I was watching Magnetism Lecture Part 3, I noticed that Ken made a little mistake, and so I thought I would make a short video on that. Now, I'm not doing this to make fun of Ken or to say Ken Wheeler's wrong, as tempting as that is. In my humble opinion, he made a mistake and I would like to try to fix it. So first I'll play the video clip, then I will show you the problem.
The diagram on the left, well, I have a god of respect for Charles Proteus Steinmetz, is incorrect. There are no straight lines in Mother Nature's universe. This is the electric field conductor. The dotted lines that are radial to the center conductor are meant to be dielectric lines. And of course the circular are meant to be magnetic. On the left we have an image that's incorrect. On the right we have a correct image. Everything in Mother Nature is curvilinear. This image is courtesy of Brian Kerr. Since 95% of the, or higher, of the images on the internet of the supercell or ferrocell are mine. I snagged this one off the internet and turns out this one's Brian Kerr's image. I have countless images like this, but this one is his.
First of all, you couldn't really see what was on the screen very well, so I've replicated it here. The image on the right is a ferrocell image from Brian Kerr's YouTube page. The image on the left is from Charles Proteus Steinmetz's book, Waves, Impulses, and Other Transients, that I showed you in a previous video. So in this video, Ken Wheeler says that the image on the left is wrong. But the problem is, Ken is assuming that this image corresponds to the pole of a magnet. But it doesn't. Here you can see the two figures from Steinmetz's book seen side by side. The image on the right, Ken Wheeler recognizes as the field geometry around and between two wires, as in the power transmission wires. If the image on the right is the field geometry surrounding two wires, then the image on the left must be the field geometry surrounding one wire. So Ken's assumption is wrong. The image on the left does not correspond to the pole of a magnet. The so-called poles of the magnet are orthogonal to this picture. Keep in mind that the dot in the middle of this field geometry is a cross-section of the wire. As you can see from the image on the right, when the current is moving towards you, it is as if there is a south pole on the left and the north pole on the right. As you can see, the virtual magnets are orthogonal to, or at right angles to, the direction of the wire, which in this case is into the page and out of the page. If you put another wire beside the original wire, and if the current is going in the same direction, then you get the field geometry of the two-wire situation. In order to look at the so-called pole of this field geometry, we would have to look at the field geometry exactly orthogonal to this image. That is, you would have to look into the page and out of the page. I wonder what that might look like. For linear propagating electromagnetic fields, like light, it might look something like this. This can be visualized as a helix wave or a spring. For an electromagnetic field surrounding a magnet, which is not propagating through space, but instead propagating around the magnet in a precessional fashion, you will see something like this. In the image on the left, the field geometry is precessing through space in time, thus the helix pattern. In the image on the right, the field geometry is precessing through time in space, thus the hypertrochoid pattern. The image on the left is referred to as circular polarized light. The image on the right can also be thought of as polarized light, only it is confined to the magnet. Long story short, this does not correspond to this. Instead, it corresponds to this. The standard way of depicting isolated charge can be seen on the right. The blue one depicts a negative charge, and the red one depicts a positive charge. I believe Charles Proteus Steinmetz's depiction of an isolated charge on the left is much more accurate than the standard depiction. Although the standard picture seems to show the electropotential lines of tension, it does not include the circular magnetokinetic lines of pressure, which must be there according to the principle of incommensurability. Both field geometries must be present. So Steinmetz wasn't wrong. But the mainstream depiction of charge is wrong. It is missing the magnetokinetic lines of pressure. So there you have it. These two pictures do not correspond to the same thing, and therefore cannot be compared. Ken Wheeler was wrong about Steinmetz being wrong. In my humble opinion, of course.